Hey everyone, back in Utah for the first snowmobile ride of the season, technically. So up here at the Monte Cristo Range with my son Andrew, meeting a couple friends. Got a lot of snow, had some blizzard conditions yesterday. We'll see what we get into. We're gonna get the sleds unloaded and head up the mountain.
I hauled my new Arctic Cat Catalyst out here to Utah. Now remember, this is the Riot, this is the crossover sled. We're gonna take it out. The snow's supposed to be pretty deep today. We're loading the snowmobiles up here on Andrew's sled bed. We went up to his friend's house, we unloaded our snowmobiles, put him in his friend's trailer. We're gonna head up to the Monte Cristo Range. They have a bunch of snow up here. Maybe bringing the Riot today was not a good move, and we're just gonna have to see. The sled is still in break-in mode. I literally have 3 miles on the snowmobile. This is day number one. We're getting the snowmobiles unloaded here, and we're gonna head up. Visibility is really low. It looks pretty good here right now, but no, when we got back, it was very low. The snow was deep. I should have brought Andrew's other mountain sled today, but we did get a few miles on and got some miles on the Riot, so that was good, and got the trailer heated up, and we're heading back, and we're going to do it all over again tomorrow. The snow was blowing so hard today, I literally took no riding footage at all. And it's Saturday morning. We're leaving Andrew's place, heading back up to the Monte Cristo Range. But here's kind of how it all went. Mm-hmm. day number two of snowmobiling in Utah is complete. We're going to head back to Andrew's house. Got to do a little checking on some sleds in his garage and do it all over again tomorrow. Sunday morning, there's going to be five of us riding today, so we moved Andrew's snowmobiles up to his friend's house north, and we're unloading the snowmobiles here. We're going to load them in his trailer, and we're going to head back up the Monte Cristo Range. Alright guys, this is my third day up here riding, and it looks like we might actually have some visibility today. They got probably another good foot of snow overnight just down here in the parking lot, so up top probably a little more, but we're getting ready to head out. There's five of us today, so let's see what today brings.
Don't stop there!
Pretty deep back here. Gonna do an old depth check here. Well, yeah, but you're still on snow. Oh yeah.
Tight down there.
We're ready. Oh yeah, that's pretty deep.
As you can see, today was a pretty deep day up here. I did very little filming. Unfortunately, I missed some good opportunities because I didn't have the camera rolling. Someone was always getting stuck. But anyways, that's going to do it for day number three up here. Now I'm going to go work for a few days in Idaho, and we're going to do it all again next weekend. I headed up to Idaho and went to Farm Equipment USA, both of their locations, one in Jerome, Idaho, the other one in Fruitland. We went out and visited a farm or a ranch. We demoed a 6135 Deutz Fahr tractor feeding some cattle. If you've not seen this video, I do have this video already up on my YouTube channel. Now let's go back to Utah and go snowmobiling. And I am now back in Utah, so I kept my Catalyst in Andrew's garage. I loaded it up, and I come up here to the Monte Cristo Range late one afternoon. He was working, he was unable to come up today, so I pretty much just kept it on the trail, but I did put 60 miles on it, so should have it pretty well into the break-in period here. Overall, I like the handling of it, and like I said, mostly trail riding here. I don't want to venture too far off the trail since I was by myself, and there was not a lot of people up here this afternoon. here's a few pictures I took of the cattle. So I was up here. Now I'm going to head back to the parking lot. I'm going to load it up, and Andrew and I are going to ride the next 2 days up here, but I'm probably going to ride his other mountain sled. And here we are the very next day. Andrew and I got the mountain sleds loaded up, and we are heading back up to the Monte Cristo Range. Snowblind right through here.
Thank you.
today's ride, Andrew and I are headed up to Logan, Franklin, Furnace area. We stopped at a Maverick gas station in Logan. We actually ran into a bunch of people Andrew knew from the Snowmobile Club, the Davis County Snowmobile Club, back near his home. So we're going to meet them in the parking lot here once we're all suited up and ride with them. We might have a pretty good sized group today. We left pretty early this morning because I'm told if you don't get up here early, you're not going to get a parking spot. And it looks like things are filling up. And after getting the whole squad together, there is 12 of us out here today.
Good job.
Yeah. Thank you.
really good day up here in the Logan Franklin Basin area. Definitely hope to get back here and ride again. Even with the big group, we really got around good and we got to a lot of places. Very little trail riding done today, just a lot of good sights. So good group of people to ride with. We're now going to head back to the parking lot, load up the sleds, and head back to Andrew's house. And I thought we rode in Utah the whole day. Actually, you can tell by what my Garmin tracked here, we was actually in Idaho most of the day and very little in Utah. Once we got back to Andrews, got the snowmobiles unloaded, we cleaned up, we headed to downtown Salt Lake City to Snowmobile Pizza. Now Andrew and my daughter-in-law have been here several times. I've never been here. Pizza was good. It was a pretty neat place, and I would say these people probably like Arctic Cat, because that's mostly what we saw here was Arctic Cat snowmobiles and Arctic wear. And I got to spend time with my granddaughter, which made the trip all the more memorable. Then it was time to start heading east. Just a short 22-hour drive from Andrew's place in Utah to mine in Ohio. Overall, the drive home was pretty good. Very little incidents, a little bit of snow here and there, but nothing too serious. And that is going to wrap up this video. If you did like this video, please go down there and hit that like button. Feel free to leave a comment. If you're new to my channel, I would really appreciate it if you would hit that subscribe button. And you can also follow me along on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok at Farmhand Mike. As always, thank you for watching and supporting my social media. Home sweet home.